Hi, everybody. I'm Joshua Jay, and this is How SnapDocs Works in Under 10 Minutes. All right, let's get started. So I'm at the home screen for snapdocs.com, okay? I'm going to explain a little bit about how algorithms work and how this platform uses that to rank you and present your account to people who are trying to find a notary. Now, SnapDocs is like any other platform, right? Google, Facebook, Instagram, et cetera. It uses an algorithm to decide how to rank people and present them, et cetera. Now, the more that you use a platform, Facebook, Instagram, Google, SnapDocs, right? The more you use a platform, the more that algorithm will reward your profile or your account by presenting it to more people, right? Your reach will be further. Now, with SnapDocs, there's a couple ways that your profile gets presented to individuals, right? And it is based on location. So if I were to be an escrow officer or any kind of agency looking for a notary in a particular area, I have one of two ways to try that out. So just to give you an idea without signing in as an escrow account agent, if you go to notary signing agents, right, there's two ways to check this out. One is by an address right here, and the second one is by scrolling down and browsing by state and then by city. So there is a difference in this, okay? And I'll tell you why. So this address right here is based off of Google. So if I start typing in numbers, it's gonna populate different addresses that start with that, right, with that chain all across the US, and all of that is based on Google Maps. I know this because down there at the bottom right, it says powered by Google, okay? So that's where this is. So if I were to type in a zip code, which is the norm of when individuals are trying to find a notary, it populates ranked notary publics or notaries public, you know, within that zip code. Now that zip code is a large radius, right? And that radius encompasses X amount of notaries. So compared to my peers, right? I don't like to say competitors because there's an abundance of signings out there. All right, we need to help each other out as notaries. So compared to my peers, I don't rank number one. I ranked the C number one, number two, number three, four, five, six, seven. I am ranked number eight, okay? Now, I'll explain why here in a second. Now, if I go back out and I go and I scroll down and I search by state and then by city, okay? Kentucky and then Fort Knox, because that's where I operate out of. And that zip code I gave you was Fort Knox zip code, all right? The zip code itself encompasses Fort Knox and parts of the surrounding cities, Elizabethtown, Radcliffe, et cetera. Here, it's only encompassing Fort Knox itself, okay? So for this search, I rank number one. Why? Because the amount of notaries I am being compared to and ranked against my peers is a lot smaller, all right? You'll see that there's one, two, three, four, five, six notaries that are within Fort Knox itself. Okay, so out of those six, I'm number one. Yay! All right. But let's take a deeper dive into why. All right. And we'll compare the two here in a second. So on the offset, when you are an escrow agent or any agency using SnapDocs trying to find notaries, it's going to present it just like this. Okay. And you get to see profile photos. So you can get an idea of how that notary will be dressed when they're going to your signing and representing you as the escrow officer or similar, okay? I'm gonna keep using escrow officer just because that's the norm, all right? Title agency, et cetera. So if I click on my my profile, it's gonna show you a couple things. One, that I'm SnapDocs verified. Very important, okay? Again, the more you use the platform, the better your profile is gonna rank. And also, the more confidence you're gonna instill on the person who's trying to hire you. Right, I have my brief little bio right here, and that's all on you, however you want to be creative with it, etc. And then a way to contact me right down here. On the right-hand side, you're going to see a small little summary that SnapDocs has put together for the individuals looking for a notary to make them better decide which notary to choose. So you'll see that I have verified credentials that SnapDocs has said, hey, they uploaded it, we checked it out, it's good, okay? That's my ID, my commission, my E&O insurance, up to $100,000, and background check report as well, okay? You'll also see a very important thing right here, the number of signings that I've completed on the platform, all right? This isn't total for my whole life. This is just using the SnapDocs platform. So I have 107, all right? Keep in mind, the more you use the platform, the better you're going to rank, okay? And there's also another reason as well, and I'll get to that here in a second. But dual tray printer, yes or no? Laser printer, yes or no? Willing to travel, yes or no? And then last seen, this is the last time that my profile was looked at by somebody trying to hire a notary, okay? And that was yesterday. Now I'm gonna go back out to find a notary public, and I'm gonna do the one where I rank, you know, 20,000 down, okay? Oops, that's not the right zip code. 40121 is Kentucky and Fort Knox and surrounding areas. All right, so Mr. Steve Murphy is top dog. Okay, you can see he's based out of Elizabethtown, which is not Fort Knox, right? But again, this is a larger radius, so it's encompassing more notaries. If I scroll all the way down to the bottom, you're gonna see that there are pages of notaries here, okay? So within all those notaries, Mr. Steve Murphy is ranked number one. So if we click on his profile, we're gonna see the similar thing, right? SnapDocs verified. He has his version of his bio right in there, okay? On the right-hand side, you're gonna see the credentials, similar to mine, the company that he has, and then the number of SnapDocs signed and completed. And lo and behold, 559, right? That's a lot. The more you use the platform, the better it's gonna be, okay? And then everything else is yes, yes, yes. And his profile was last seen for consideration of a job today, okay? Now, if we go back out and we recompare my hyper-local group, which is what you kind of want to do on your end as well, depending on how far you want to travel. I don't do every single signing anymore just because of I have a full-time job and I have to kind of only when available type of thing. But I had 107. If I go down to Miss Crystal Blue, right, which I've used, by the way, she's a great notary. She has 24 signings on SnapDocs. A big difference from my 107, right? Now, this is only on SnapDocs profile, okay? When I found her, I didn't go through SnapDocs, I went through Google, you know, so I'm sure she does a lot of general notary work that way and has a lot more under her belt. This is just for SnapDocs, okay? So don't let that freak you out. And over time, and as you start accepting them, it's gonna rank up before you even you realize it. So we have that on there. Now, one thing that I do want to throw out to you as well, okay? When you're using SnapDocs, SnapDocs prioritizes you. They get a signing request, right? A text message is sent out. Now that mass text message is tiered, okay? Top ranking notaries, the next ranking notaries, the next ranking notaries, and so on. So that first text message goes out to all the head people, right? Whatever number the algorithm decides. A few seconds later, the next set goes out. And then the next set goes out and so on and so forth. So if you're not high ranking on SnapDocs, the text message that you receive may be one of the later tiers, which is why if you try to reply to it, it may already say this signing has already been assigned, you know, or assigned to another notary, et cetera. And that's why. Don't let that stop you or deter you, all right? Keep going. At some point, these individuals are not going to be available, right? Via signings, vacations, et cetera, it's the holidays. And you know, your status, wherever you might fall into those tiers, is gonna be more open to getting a job, okay? If you're just starting out, I would highly recommend that you take whatever job, all right? As long as it's within a distance that you're willing to travel, I wouldn't worry about making a profit just yet. I would worry about getting the job completed, getting paid, and having that added to the number of signings that you've done on SnapDocs, so that way the platform can reward you and start moving you up those text tiers. Once you get to the top text tiers, right, when you're in high priority, that is going to allow you to get those text messages first, and then you replying back will have a higher likelihood of you getting accepted, okay? Counter offers, all that kind of good stuff. So that's it. That's the whole spiel of how SnapDocs works and how you can leverage that. And that was it, the whole SnapDocs platform in under 10 minutes.